Hello and welcome back to your own channel Indian Defense Analysis, where we bring to you all the latest development happening in the defense sector.
As per the latest update, DRDO has successfully test-fired cluster munition version of Pinaka rocket at Pokhran. Each rocket of Pinaka will have 234 bomblets and will be used for area suppression strikes against enemy troop or vehicle concentrations. The cluster munition can be fired from all the versions of Pinaka, that is MK1, MK2 and guided Pinaka. It is also called DPICM variant or dual purpose improved conventional munition. The DPICM development is a collaborative efforts of Yantra India, Munitions India and Advanced Weapons, the newly formed DPSUs of erstwhile OFP along with DRDO. If we have to talk about the Pinaka rocket system, it will take us nearly 1 hour to explain its complete feature. We will make a separate video on explaining different versions of Pinaka. In the lights of current test, we will focus our discussion on warheads or different type of munitions which Pinaka can fire. This itself will be a long video but an exciting one, so stay tuned with us till the end. A warhead is a part of rocket or missile that inflicts desired damage to the target and renders it incapable of performing its intended function. In general, the damage to a target can be due to physical, thermal, and psychological effects. Pinaka can fire different types of warheads, which are preformed fragment PF warheads, incendiary warheads, submunition warheads, DPICM warheads, ATM-STM warheads and thermobaric warheads. PF warheads are for anti-personnel and to cause damage to soft-skinned vehicles, radar installations and FOL dumps, etc. The warhead is effective up to 60 meter radius. The kill mechanism consists of two layers of 6 mm tungsten alloy spheres as preformed fragments laid over a filament wound FRP module. Inside portion of module is filled with high explosive composition, that is Dentex, which on detonation propels the fragment at high velocities. The warhead is detonated at a predetermined height above the target to achieve optimum performance. The warhead is initiated by a proximity fuse. This type of warhead is mainly used for setting fire on inflammable targets like FOL dumps and ammunition depots. The incendiary composition is housed inside a container along with a buster's charge. These containers are hermetically sealed. Five such incendiary containers are housed inside a steel tube. The steel tube is provided with notches on outer surface so that secondary fragmentation effect can be achieved. The incendiary rocket is initiated at 300 meter HOB. Incendiary composition contains 6:40 ratio of Jadar and red phosphorus. Warhead is effective up to 75 meter radius. The submunition warheads are deployed against large area installations. Such warhead consists of a number of submunitions or bomblets housed inside a warhead structure. They are dispensed at terminal end with the help of common injection mechanism. Three such types of warheads, that is DPICM, anti-tank munition ATM and soft target munition STM, have been developed for Pinaka rockets. Each submunition has its independent kill mechanism, stabilization and fusing system. Their lethality is derived from the ability of one or few bomblets to destroy a major component of the target or to effect of incendiary warhead infrastructure damage to the target. They contain a fragment casing or shape charge to achieve desired effect. The recent Pinaka test was using the DPICM munition. DPICM is also referred as bomblet. The DPICM warhead is initiated at HOB of around 750 meters above the ground. On injection, each bomblet gets separated and stabilizes through a ribbon attached to it. On impact, bomblet fuse functions and destroys the target. In case if it fails, ST mechanism works and demolishes bomblet. ATM or STM warheads are used to stop the advancement of approaching column of enemy personnel STM or armored vehicles ATM. ATM warhead houses 18 numbers of anti-tank submunitions, whereas STM warhead houses nearly 48 numbers of submunitions. Thermobaric warheads contain slow burning explosive composition that keep their explosive impulse on the target for a longer duration. Thermobaric compositions are essentially metal enriched and oxygen deficient. Typical detonation velocities of thermobaric explosives are of 3 to 4 kilometers per second. Unlike conventional high explosive warheads, the thermobaric warheads undergo simultaneous detonation and dispersion.
This was today's update. Please let us know what is your views about these in comment section. Feel free to post your comments and suggestions about any topic related to defense sector on which you want to hear from us. With this, I would like to say goodbye and Jai Hind, friends. Please like and subscribe our video if you have not done already. We'll be soon back with more interesting and amazing development happening in defense sector.